can live from his dream.
Yes.
When we have handed over everything to the master, we are free. Technically speaking, we are bound. We are bound not to anybody else. We are bound to our master, who is behind our thought, word and deed. Now actually we are bound because the sense of individuality feels separate from the master. So spiritual journey means making a person completely free. That freedom can come only when all our thoughts, all our deeds, all our words are dedicated to Him. Total submission to His will. Subservience to His will. Surrender to His will. Whatever way you can interpret. This is what is needed. All of our spiritual practices should culminate in this. So while taking up the in-depth study, like this we can choose and then pray to Him. I am praying to you. I feel now that I am chanting your name. Like all other activities, I own up everything. But actually, if you are not there, I cannot do anything. But somehow, the sense of agency does not hand over this. I have to hand over the whole thing and become your chela, become your seva. Seva. I should become your slave. Then only I will become free. Such type of prayer. If you go back to the heart pouring, you will find the same theme in every heart pouring, in different paragraphs. She wants to get this stabilized. I am nothing, O Lord, you are everything. We are only hearing and telling, but we are not here. We have not handed over. So this is the final culmination. It may not be easy for us to complete, but let us try in whatever form. As suggested 2 days back, from our morning to evening activity, we will try to bring this dimension in 1 or 2 or 3. Yesterday, for example, we landed in Bangalore for evening. Because of the publicity of this COVID spur again, the Tamil Nadu government is also imposing lot of strictures. So the devotee in whose name and in whose house he stayed, they wanted to have a small satsang, means small satsang. So they teleported about 50 people. And they were able to get a small hall. When we went there. After 2 years, we are seeing Coimbatore devotees. So the entire program went on till there was no other program excepting Ramnam for 5 to 10 minutes, and then we were sharing what had happened on the 27th December 2021 at the ashram. All the came. Everything went up beautifully. Everybody was surprised how this could go. So he had, when he gave the prompting, he thought to it that everything goes out well to the satisfaction of our concern. Today we had no idea about this place. Absolutely no idea. We would have passed through a place called Chilligal. From there, you know, we have no idea. But can you see the photos? This is a shrine. This is something like a forest. In the midst of the forest, this building and one more building is there. And in a shrine, we are in a position to get ourselves connected. You cannot imagine us here yet. Similarly, we have to bring in. When you gave the prompting, we should have this 4 to 5 through internet, through Google Meet. He could even get it arranged in such a far off place, which is about 1 hour drive from Chandigarh. We have to cover about 16 to 18 hairpin bends. Human habitation is very, very, very limited. Trees and trees and trees, forest. A few costly estate is there, I saw. So in this such a beautifully brought out by one devotee, and we were wondering whether this internet facility will be there. Tomorrow we will try to show you outside, it is inside the building. Then you will see only trees, shrubs and forest.
You were told about 2000 years above the sea level. So while you are mentioning,
every time we have to keep on thinking what is not possible for you. If you feel that it should be done, you make it possible in the apparently impossible place. Where these facilities are not likely. Because you need, you know, even if we handle the dongle, something should be there to transmit, you know. Some tower or something like that. But luckily, you are seeing us, we can see you. So nothing is impossible. Every time, suppose we keep on bringing this idea, that whenever you want it, you will make it all right. And if you don't want it, however much I may forget and try to do by myself, I may not be able to do it. So, like that, slowly we will try to learn one by one. Because then only probably the mind will get trained to hand over the whole thing. In one go, it will not. It's a beautiful word. A slave is a slave who is free, no? What is that word?
Slave is a slave because he is free.
A slave is a slave because he is free. Because he doesn't bother about anything, you know. Master will take care of everything. Otherwise, we have to take care of everything. The master will not interfere. He will be only an upadrashta.
he will be a witness. But actually, when the handing over takes place, he takes over. And that was what happened in Papa's case. That was what had been chronicled in Inquest of God. So we are, as devotees, we are not asking him anything here now. You have shown us, you have made us intellectually understood. We know that. Even through so many things, you are demonstrating it also. But still we fail to recognize it as a reality. So from the smallest to the grossest, you are planning, you are doing. You may make me say that I am doing, I am going there, I am coming here. But somewhere in the corner of my heart, if I have that feeling that you are making me to say that, for the sake of Vyavahar, then everything is alright. So we have to keep on hammering this. I am a slave, but I think I am the master. Remove that assumed masterhood and enable me to realize that I am a slave of you. Because then only I realize I will become free. Then I don't have to bother about the result at all. Because I may not be planning or desiring also, you know, in that case. You will be doing everything for me. Just like when we were parents, or when we were children, our parents were deciding everything for us. Though they gave us a little freedom to ask for this or that, ultimately we know they will take care of us. So whenever we feel anything, we rush up to them and tell them. Technically speaking, we are slaves and they are our master. But that particular word, we would not have understood or we would not have uttered. But now looking back to our old life, childhood life, we will know a slave is a slave because he is free. We did not have to bother much. Everything was planned, thought of, arranged by our parents. So Papa wants to dwell upon this through the words of Swami Ramakrishna. You all know that Papa was very much inspired by the wisdom teachings of Swami Ramakrishna. That's why he quoted this. Very, very happy that we are in a position to identify certain expressions in the book that will give us more clarity in our spiritual journey. This is in-depth study. But it should not be an intellectual exercise. That is the only thing. We try to connect it with our own life. Our own life. Every day we should try. Whatever that had happened, we must try. You made me to do it, but you made me to forget it, and you made me to feel that I have done it. Please. Like that, you know, it can be a dialogue. This is very, very important. This is the very purpose of going through Inquest of God in depth. Because in every page he highlights this. In the seemingly, apparently, adverse situation, how it has transformed into a positive one, how it helped him to move towards maintaining the presence of God. Just like, you know, Swami Padmanabhanji Maharaj told us about the second chapter. People are deluded when they say, I do this, I do that, this is mine, that is mine.
But actually everything is done by you. Everything is yours only. My prayer is that I should be completely taken over by you and remove the I-ness in me. Exactly this is what is echoed in this 32nd chapter. Same idea. Second chapter and the third. And this is the keynote. This is the pivotal thing that we should ponder over and pray. Pray. That is why they are called childlike, you know. Then we become childlike. We don't plan. All these things will help us to develop this sort of attitude. Otherwise the me and mine will become very, very strong. Even day for yesterday when we were telling you that you are moving to a new place and we don't know whether internet facilities are available. As you all know, we don't have any practical experience in handling all these things, these computer friendly activities. But so happened, you know, they gave from ashram, they put everything in the ready mix stage. And then you told me you press here, you know. And after that we were not sure. But the moment we came here, our friends here were, you know, they said, yes, it is possible. They have also bought in a dongle, suppose it goes wrong. If that is being charged, for tomorrow it will be a backup. Just wonder, you know, these are from the Javaharic, we can say one. But from the spiritual angle when we see how he is seated in everybody, you know. He is seated in the laptop, he is seated in the dongle, he is seated in the person. And how the coordination takes place beautifully without much telling, without much talking or planning, like what we are telling. Apparently the gadget, the equipment, the persons are organizing it. But we find the thread now. We don't have to superimpose something and then say. So in every happening, suppose we try to see his finger of hand, finger of person. Probably we might get the clue that we are all slaves only and he is the master. And the master has been gracious enough to make us feel that we are masters. And at times whenever he gives the knock, kicks the knock, we suddenly cry and say you are the master. And as soon as the pain is over, we again say we are the masters. In God experience, Papa talks about one anecdote. One sannyasi or a spiritual aspirant who felt that he had scaled the heights, he was telling others, everything is Brahman, everything, all else is Mithya. So a couple of youngsters have been hearing this. Then they took him and bodily lifted and made him to go down in the well with all his resistance, you know, though he said nothing doing, he was made to go within. And from there he started asking those people to lift him up. Those, they said, everything is Brahman, you know, all these are Mithya, why should you do that? He said, no, that I was only telling, I agree. This is not Mithya, this is reality. Again he was taken out. As soon as he landed on the surface, again he started telling. So again he was put like that. We are like that only, you know. Whenever we are in trouble, acute trouble, and when we pray, and when we feel we have been saved, we used to feel for a second, for a time. And again we are back to square one. We should remember this. Today you made me to think more and more about the slave and the master. You are the master and I am the slave. But I forget this. And I feel, you know, I am the master. And whenever I am in need of it, I will come to you, that's all. Otherwise, everything is being done by me. Everything is planned by me. Everything is chalked out by me. Everything is drafted by me. Like that, you know, that is how I have been thinking. But today you make me to think. Am I not there behind you? Am I not there behind every other object and person? How does the situation take place? How the beautiful arrangement takes place? Why don't you see my hand in that? So during these sattvic moments, suppose we try to practice that, then any incident that is happening, we must try to see the situation, the person, the object has been brought about by him and him only. When he would have given us a sankalpa. Yes, today one more thing happened. Yesterday evening, one ashram devotee who is there in Australia, she had come to Coimbatore. She wanted very much to join, but geographically, you know, the place where the distance is too much, so they cannot come. The meeting was a problem. Everywhere traffic jam is there. So she telephoned, then he said, don't worry about it. We'll meet later. Today morning, while we were coming from Coimbatore to this place, suddenly at a particular point, somebody in our group said, where is her house? Exactly a few feet before the vehicle reached, this dialogue has taken place. Immediately a person who knows her house, they say, it is very near, from here, you know, it will take hardly 1 kilometer. Immediately we went there. She was about to lock the door and go away, go to some school with her son. Fraction of a second. We went there, got down from the car and moved toward the house. She was just closing and coming out. Suddenly she saw and, she said she couldn't contain herself. Then it went about 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Then we said, your sankalpa is so strong that she made us to think about you just before 5 minutes and the vehicle was passing through. And you see the timing is, if it was 6 minutes, we would have come here, we would not have seen you. But we arranged in such a way that we landed at a particular time when you were about to lock outside. No, you were there outside. What do you attribute? So as a spiritual aspirant, we try to attribute that he planned everything beautifully. Then yesterday he made us to say it will be difficult for you to come all the way, don't worry. Today he thought it that exactly at that particular moment, she is coming out and we are going in. And none of us have to do anything extra. No? We were on our way to this place. And exactly 5 minutes before we reached here, only this was the thought of her came. So like that, you know, in all incidents suppose we try to bring. How he meticulously takes care of the needs, sentiments, desires, then if it has to take up, if it has to become a reality throughout my life, I should become a slave and I should accept that he is my master. Immediately after this session, he may again go back to the old stage, that of the master. But today he is bringing it out in the form of small, small incident. Yes, anything else? So many are there, but nobody is telling. Any other point?
Hello, Swamiji.
Ah.
I want to ask one small question.
When
emotions are the part of ego, because thoughts and mind is same, then emotions are also coming through mind. Whether the emotions are part of ego, and while we are chanting Ramnam, our eyes are filled with tears. So, how can it be? Is it out of ego or it is devotion?
Emotions again.
Again? Shall I repeat, Swamiji?
To establish a close relationship.
That's
a fine. And put it now to the individual level, what is there? It stays only for a fleeting time. But if it is not coming from the individual level, the divine level, then it stays with us. When we see a dear most one, when somebody passes away, dear most, we get some tears, we get emotionally charged. You have to find out now whether it's coming from this. Anyway, it's a gift of God. Unnecessarily, the sense of individuality owns it and says that it is my emotion. It's a noble thing he has given. Because bhakti paravashyam, no? When we have devotionally charged attitude towards anything, we get this emotional feeling. It is a gift of him. If at all the ego says, then it is mine. It is only that we are blocking it. That's all. And just like the slave and master, we think we are the deciding people. Whenever an emotion wells up, where identification with the other happens, immediately we remember him, you know. I would not have been able to embrace you totally, but you have made me to embrace at least one person, two person, one situation, one object. Slowly we can move towards the higher one. If we start analyzing what is emotion, what does it give? When somebody passes away, we become emotional. When somebody says something, and if it affects our individuality, we become emotional. We become angry. Anger is also emotional. So you check up whether it stems from the individual level. If it is the individual level, we can attribute, at least for argument's sake here, it is from the sense of individuality level. But divine emotions are made known to us through these individual emotions initially. When you hear a song, where the devotee pleased the Almighty Lord. And you know what happens in you, you just watch. And instead of trying to find out whether this relates to the ego, whether it relates to the divine, why not we concentrate more and more on the divine emotion? Then the so-called individual level emotions will also slowly get dried up. Because one saint was telling, emotions are good, emotionalism is bad. Sentiments are good, sentimentalism is bad. That means, emotions means are pure. But when it is converted into emotionalism, that means I add the sense of individuality. The other one is spontaneous, free from self-interest. And the second one, the other one is full of, it could be due to an attachment. It could be due to a possessiveness. It could be due to our a sense of insecurity, fear, anxiety. So that all stems from the individual level. But we personally feel that as ordinary individuals, we are all subject to such type of things. So instead of concentrating on that, let us try to develop the divine emotion, you know. So that all these things will be all slowly converted into divine emotion. We can take him into task. Through that particular person, when you made a comment, you did not make me accept it or resign to it. But on the contrary, you developed a negative emotion in me. Like that, you know, even that could be a process of transferring the whole thing to him. So whenever we feel emotions at the individual level, as spiritual aspirants, let us try to go through this process. We may fail initially, but ultimately, you know, we will know that it is he. It became at the emotional level because I have not become so pure now. That's all. My equipment should become so pure so that God dealing with it directly gets reflected, not distracted or distorted. As we keep on thinking, you know, we don't have to separate, you know, why this is from individual level, this is from, everything is from his level. We are praying to him that we assume this. Even spiritually highly evolved people, they may also react like this, you know. But what is the difference? They don't feel it inside. They don't own it. So apparently their actions may be of the same order. So any point that comes up, suppose we try to connect it to him, then probably, you know, we'll be, at least in snail speed, we'll be moving towards. You kindly go through the outpouring every day, the second or third one, where he says, you know, every activity is dedicated to him. Whenever, you know, we are unable to maintain this, suppose we go through that, walking, eating, talking, you know, everything he lists. Let it be in your name, let it be for your sake. That gives us the picture. We try to become detached. And watching that how he is doing. Outwardly our body, mind, intellect may be acting, may be talking, may be reacting. But all these things are being witnessed. That stage we should get. This is what we are praying now. You have given me an individuality, you have made me to, you sit in an environment, and you make that environment to act, or you make up to act or react, or pro-act, or act, something, you know, something, so many things you are making us to do. But please make us understand that you are behind it, you are behind it, you are behind it. So that nothing I will take it for myself. We always remember Pooja Swami Siddhidanandaji's words, you know. As is my own, I pass it on to him. It's a wonderful word. As is my own means that is my practice. Owning anything is not there in his mind. Whether it is objects, emotions or thought. So we try to remember that. As is my wound, I pass on. Apparently there will be some question, some answer, some reaction will be there. But Swamiji has already passed it on to him. Including his equipment. And through that equipment, probably God wanted to say, which we call it as his reaction. So, and further in all his states, you know, and once, you know, Mataji was, in our language, you know, in our language, when Mataji was not at all comfortable, about the progress ashram devotees are making. So, she became restless, you know, she, apparently. So, Pooja Swamiji said, he went and asked, when you know everything is happening by God, why should Mataji, you having failed the height, why should you feel so? Immediately she gave a hearty laugh and said, now do you think, who is doing this? So even the act of so-called grumbling for a noble cause, you know, not for anything personal. Apparently, it looks like a grumbling, a complaint. But when Mataji immediately, spontaneously, you know, laughed and said, whom do you think I am talking? Whom do you think I am complaining? Like that, you know. All these things will come back to us. Then only we are in the process of handing over everything. Because otherwise it becomes a theory and intellectual exercise. These are all the things that have demonstrated. And slowly when we try to connect up everything to him, we also find the joy. Like what we share. In his poem, Papa, tomorrow we will try to read it out. We don't have that book here. You may also please go through that book. There are so many poems, you know, of which two we can select. Normally we have to share the, one is I find him everywhere. The second one is, that is all outside. The other one is, I find him inside in the form of various what. That will give you some idea. Through eyes, through ears, through thoughts, you know. How do you express? Still with all this attendant, we still feel, you know, God, bringing God dimension is something that an outside activity. At the moment, he is making us to hear, no? At the moment, he is making us to share. At the moment, through this, what do you call this? Laptop. At the moment, through internet. So instead of thinking that we have arranged, why not we start thinking that it is he who has arranged? Because in our core of being, he is there, no? the core of our being as life, as awareness, as intelligence, as creativity. He comes into play, all these things. So we will try, we have to try this. There is no other method, there is no shortcut. Nobody can put us and place it there. Right from everything we have to keep on. Atta, you made us to hear this today. At the time of sitting here, we have no idea what is to be shared. And when something is asked, what is to be shared, that also we don't know. But he keeps on telling you, say this, you say that, no. This should be structured to as many activities as possible. Then only we will get over this doubt and we will get the technique, you know. A technique which got evolved in ourselves. A technique not we got it from outside. Because a technique, if we get it from outside, it will not stay long. Because it is not suiting to our equipment. But a technique evolved by ourselves, suiting to our equipment, will definitely stay with us. And for that we have enough experience in our life that wholehearted, dedicated, committed, focused, concentrated activity. The teacher would have helped us. The person who helped us to sit in the cycle initially when we had no balance, she would have helped us. But ultimately the balance, you know, the balance we got, it came from within. The know-how or the intelligence or the memory, is not by learning by heart, you know. Learning by heart is also it's a process. We were all asked to learn by heart so many things because to train the mind, you know, to dwell on the same thing again and again and again and again. When the mind is trained, and then the mind brings out what is stored behind the words. And that is why the concept of examination came, and without any support, without any external support, through some probing questions, what is assimilated or what is absorbed by us, what has become our own, that comes out in the form of answers. Okay, similarly, we have to apply the same attitude here. We try to absorb or assimilate whatever we have been made to watch, made to observe, made to learn, and then see in ourselves, and we experiment, we test, and then we come out. There is no difference between the outer and the inner as far as this absorption, assimilation is concerned. And we don't look up to the teacher to answer for us. If we have not correctly answered, we will not get marked. Then we start thinking, where did we go wrong? So we have to go back to our own life. When we started working, you know, we would not have become a master in what we were doing. Later on, you know, when we started doing the same job, we started bringing out new methods, and the boss definitely encouraged us. And all technical know-how, you know, the skill, you say the management skill or something like that, you know. Everything has come from where? From inside. And experience is the best guide for us. When we say experience is the best guide, God makes us to observe those things. Even our own experience. Then He teaches us. If He attributes that also to our external factor, then we will not get started. So here it comes to Papa keeps on now bringing this point in our mind But why don't you start thinking everything right now? Now and here, now and here, now and here. Why do you postpone for something? Why do you wait for something to turn up and say? Why don't you start where you are now? All the emotions that well up, all the thoughts that well up, all the activities that stem from you, all the reactions you get it from outside. You start. That's what Papa keeps on telling. Don't postpone it. Now and here, now and here, now and here. We find it difficult, so we pray to Him. We understand your word now and here, but we still feel, you know, something else to be done, something else to be done, something else to be done. In that process, we don't get started. So you kindly make us implement this now and here, now itself. I think that is enough for us. When we meet tomorrow, you bring another point, please. Though all points are leading to one and the same answer, which is the final answer, let us keep on probing deeper and deeper into the various chapters, so that all these 37 chapters will give us this, you know, that will make us to start this now and here. And you may also kindly go through the outpourings. That is all for the day. We'll meet tomorrow. Same time, we hope we'll be able to. We'll not have any much problem. And only a few people are asking questions or wanted us to share something. We want everybody to bring something. Don't forget, Dina. There are so many people on the screen. Something from your own experience you are. We don't say that you should try to get it from Papa's words only. Then you tally with Papa's words. First your experience, your reaction. Your way of handling. Your efforts to bring him into the picture. Let that be the basis for this. And then refer to Papa. So that it becomes ours, you know. It should not become an academic exercise. It should become experiential. So let us all pray to Him to give us that approach. That also He has to give, agree. So we pray to Him. In order that I move correctly towards you, you guide me as to how I should move towards you. Again, I fall into the clutches of my sense of individuality and then try to think that I have to bring some outside element to move towards you. Whereas actually every moment you are providing, through my thoughts, through my words, through my deeds, and you keep on bringing this now and here dimension, but still I forget. So that is our problem. Okay now? Is it becoming clearer and clearer?
Yes, Swami. Yes.
It's
becoming
clear. Yes, we have it. Very good, very good. And you, Om Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Ram Go, Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram Go.